इम्पोर्टेंट थ्योरम। सपोज एफ इज इंटीग्रेबल ऑन क्लोज इंटरवल ए कामा बी एंड कैपिटल एफ ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल एफ ऑफ ए प्लस इंटीग्रेशन ए टू एक्स स्मॉल एफ ऑफ टी डी टी फॉर ऑल एक्स बिलोंग्स टू क्लोज इंटरवल ए कामा बी देन डेरिवेटिव ऑफ कैपिटल एफ इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल एफ ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर दैट इज डी बाई डी एक्स ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन ए टू एक्स एफ डी टी इज इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ एक्स ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर। प्रूफ। What is the given that suppose f is integrable on closed interval a comma b and capital F of x, its indefinite integral. Let us take as capital F of x is equal to capital F of a plus integration a to x f of t dt. For all x belongs to closed interval a comma b, then derivative of capital F we have to show as small f almost everywhere. Since we know that positive part of f is non-negative, negative part of f is also non-negative, and f can be written as f plus minus f minus. So assume f is greater than or equal to 0. Since this one is positive, this one is positive, so let us assume that f is greater than or equal to 0. Since in the statement clearly given that f is integrable, f is integrable on closed interval a comma b, then f is measurable and bounded almost everywhere on closed interval a comma b, since every integrable function is bounded as well as measurable. Now we define a sequence of functions fn as fn of x is equal to f of x if f of x is less than n, n if f of x is greater than or equal to n. That is, what is fn? Fn is nothing but minimum of f comma n. Minimum of, what is the first term of this sequence? f1. f1 is, I am going to compare the given function f and 1. Whichever is minimum, let us take f1. Same thing, f2, f3, so on. Since both f is measurable and every constant is also measurable, R measurable, then minimum of measurable functions is also measurable, we get that each fn is a measurable function. Also note that modulus of fn of x. What is fn of x? Minimum of these two. Minimum means it is less than or equal to f as well as less than or equal to f. Each and every term is less than or equal to n for all n. Therefore, each and every term of this sequence is bounded. Hence, each fn is bounded. Therefore, each fn is bounded and measurable. Bounded and measurable. Therefore, by the previous theorem, we get that integration a to x एफ एंड डी टी इज डिफ्रेंशिएबल ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस थ्योरम. लास्ट थ्योरम वी हैव प्रूव दैट इफ एफ इज बाउंडेड एंड मेजरेबल फंक्शन देन इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम ए टू एक्स एफ डी डी टी इज डिफ्रेंशिएबल ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर. एंड एंड डी बाई डी टी ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन ए टू एक्स एफ एन डी टी इज इक्वल टू एफ एन ऑफ एक्स ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर बाय इक्वेशन नंबर वन. देयरफॉर आई रोट दिस वन एंड दिस वन बाय यूजिंग द प्रीवियस थ्योरम बाय यूजिंग द प्रीवियस थ्योरम लास्ट थ्योरम. नाउ सिंस एफ इज बाउंडेड ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर देन वी गेट दैट लिमिट n tends to infinity fn of x is equal to f of x almost everywhere. How I can say, since each and every term of this sequence, each and every term of this sequence is less than or equal to f, f1 is less than or equal to f, f2 is less than or equal to f, f3 is less than or equal to f, therefore the given this sequence is increasing and less than or equal to f, therefore the given sequence is converges to f. Let us take this one as equation number 2. Equation number 2, by the definition of fn, it is obvious that f minus fn is greater than or equal to 0 for all n. Since fn is the minimum, fn is less than or equal to f as well as less than or equal to n. Therefore, each and every term is less than or equal to f. Each and every term is less than or equal to n. Since fn is less than or equal to f for all n, then f minus fn is greater than or equal to 0. Since we got f is measurable, each fn is measurable, difference of two measurable function is measurable. Since and limit of measurable function, sequence of measurable function is measurable. Since limit of measurable functions and difference of measurable functions is measurable, we get f minus fn is measurable for all n. Since we got each fn is measurable, limit of a measurable functions is measurable, therefore f is measurable, difference of two measurable is measurable, therefore we got f minus fn is measurable. Since each fn is bounded and f is also bounded almost everywhere, in the starting we got here f is bounded almost everywhere and we got each fn is bounded, difference of two bounded function is also bounded, then we get f minus fn is bounded almost everywhere for all n. Again I am going to use the previous theorem for this one. F minus fn is bounded almost everywhere and f minus fn is measurable. How I use the previous theorem here? Since each fn is bounded and measurable, I can use the previous theorem. A same thing here I am going to use. Since each f minus fn is bounded and measurable, therefore by the previous theorem we get that the indefinite integral gn of x, nothing but this one, इंटीग्रेशन ए टू एक्स एफ माइनस एफ एन ऑफ टी डी टी इज डिफ्रेंशिएबल ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर. इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ दिस वन इज ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर एंड डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस वन इज नथिंग बट एफ माइनस एफ एन almost everywhere. Equation number, let us take this one as equation number 3, this one as equation number 4. Since we got here f minus fn is greater than or equal to 0 for all n, then since f minus fn is greater than or equal to 0, we get that derivative of gn is greater than or equal to 0 for all n. Let us take this one as equation number 5. Equation number 5. Now we have capital F of x. In the statement clearly given, capital F of x is equal to capital F of a plus integration a to x small f of t dt by statement. This one can be written as capital F of A plus integration A to X adding and subtracting Fn, F minus Fn plus Fn dt, subtracted and added. Now this one can be written as which is equal to capital F of A plus integration a to x small f minus fn dt plus integration a to x small fn dt. Let us take this one as equation number 6. Differentiating equation number 6 with respect to x, we get differentiation of f of x is f dash of x is equal to differentiation of capital F of a constant is 0 and differentiation of this one already we got here differentiation of this one is f minus this one. Differentiation of this one is gn dash, that is gn dash of x plus, and differentiation of this one is fn of x almost everywhere by equation number 1 and equation number 4. Since already we got just now here gn dash is greater than or equal to 0 for all n by equation number 5. This one is greater than or equal to 0 plus fn of x almost everywhere by equation number 5. Since this is true for any n letting n tends to infinity, what you will get? Derivative of capital F of x is greater than or equal to limit n tends to infinity fn of x almost everywhere. But what we got? Equation number 2, limit n tends to infinity fn of x is f of x. This implies that is capital F dash of x is greater than or equal to small f of x almost everywhere by equation number 2. Therefore, capital F dash minus small f is greater than or equal to 0 almost everywhere. Let us take this one as equation number 7. Now, this one can be written as कैपिटल एफ डैश इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू एफ ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर. इंटीग्रेटिंग ऑन बोथ साइड ए टू बी, कैपिटल एफ डैश इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम ए टू बी स्मॉल एफ, विच इज इक्वल टू फ्रॉम द स्टेटमेंट फ्रॉम द हाइपोथेसिस व्हाट इज इंटीग्रेशन ए टू एक्स स्मॉल एफ ऑफ टी, कैपिटल एफ ऑफ एक्स माइनस कैपिटल एफ ऑफ ए, कैपिटल एफ ऑफ एक्स दैट इज कैपिटल एफ ऑफ अपर लिमिट माइनस कैपिटल एफ ऑफ लोअर लिमिट. दिस वन कैन बी रिटन एज कैपिटल एफ ऑफ बी माइनस कैपिटल एफ ऑफ ए बाय द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कैपिटल एफ, बाय द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कैपिटल एफ, इक्वेशन नंबर एट. अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू टेक इक्वेशन नंबर सेवन, इम्प्लाइज कैपिटल एफ डैश इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू एफ ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर. सिंस ऑलरेडी वी गॉट स्मॉल एफ इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो, कैपिटल एफ डैश इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर, सिंस स्मॉल एफ इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो. स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द प्रूफ, सिंस एफ पॉजिटिव पार्ट एंड नेगेटिव पार्ट ऑफ बोथ आर नेगेटिव वी विल गेट एफ इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो. इफ कैपिटल एफ डैश इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो, इफ डेरिवेटिव ऑफ ए फंक्शन इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू जीरो, देन वी से दैट कैपिटल एफ इज मोनोटोनिकली इंक्रीजिंग फंक्शन ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर. नाउ आई कैन यूज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ लीबेक थ्योरम, देयरफॉर बाय द लीबेक थ्योरम. What the Liebeck theorem says, if any function is monotonically increasing function, then its derivative is differentiable and integration of its derivative is less than or equal to f of b minus f of a. We get capital F dash is measurable and integration a to b कैपिटल एफ डैश इज लेस देन और इक्वल टू कैपिटल एफ ऑफ बी माइनस कैपिटल एफ ऑफ ए, इक्वेशन नंबर नाइन. इक्वेशन नंबर एट सेज इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी कैपिटल एफ डैश इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू दिस वन एंड दिस वन इज लेस देन और इक्वल टू, फ्रॉम एट एंड नाइन वी गेट इंटीग्रेशन ए टू बी capital F dash is equal to capital F of B minus capital F of A. Now again from the statement, what is capital F of B minus capital F of A? Integration A to B small f dt, which is nothing but which is equal to integration A to B small f by the definition of capital F in the statement. This implies integration A to B capital F dash minus integration A to B small f is equal to zero. This implies integration A to B capital F dash minus small f is equal to zero. Equation number 10. What the equation number 7 says, capital F dash is greater than or equal to F almost everywhere. This implies capital F dash minus F is greater than or equal to 0 almost everywhere. Now, capital F dash minus F is greater than or equal to 0 almost everywhere, then its integral is also greater than or equal to 0. Since integral is 0, then it is only possible if this one is equal to 0 almost everywhere. Hence, equation number 10 is possible only if capital F dash minus small f is equal to 0 almost everywhere. That is, capital F dash is equal to small f almost everywhere.